You have families whose child has, maybe they came here for early education, which a lot of our adult participants have. They went from Fraser Center into public school and received very good services from K through 12. Then they graduated high school, but they don't have the Medicaid waiver. What do they do now?
Fraser Center provides supports to adults with intellectual and developmental disabilities, helping them to be engaged in the community through employment, volunteer work, adult education, civic engagement, and we do that largely through funding from Medicaid waivers.
Individuals are eligible to receive a free public education until they're 22 years of age. After that 22nd birthday, they are an adult in society, and many families don't realize that the person they've been caring for now will need some way of supporting themselves in a job, attending a day service, or functioning in society. The Medicaid waiver pays for those services.
Those waivers allow us to use Medicaid funding to provide services that keep people out of more expensive institutional care and engaged in their communities and giving back.
For a lot of families who come to that point when they don't have the Medicaid waiver and their child is out of school, it really means that child may sit at home and watch TV or go stay at grandma's house.
What do they do? Do they sit on the couch? Do they have someone to support them? What do their families do when they have a loved one who needs some extra support, but there's no one to give that support?
Many families in Georgia find themselves unable to maintain employment, and older parents find it difficult to retire because they are caring for an adult child who has a disability.
There are a lot of families that struggle to meet financial needs to bring their children to a place like this. I hear phone calls all the time with moms and dads calling, and some of them a lot of times are in tears because they cannot simply afford it.
The Flourish Fund is going to help us meet the needs of those people who are on the waiting list to go ahead and get them in, start providing services while they're getting approval for their Medicaid waiver.
That fund will allow participants to access our services while they wait for waiver funding.
And just being able to get that person 1 or 2 days at the Fraser Center, where they come in and everybody says hello and everybody smiles and you have lunch with your friends, you go on a community outing, maybe you go to Fernbank Museum to watch a film, maybe you talk with one of our staff members about how you would like to find a job one day or what kind of a job you might want to have. It may not seem like a lot, but 2 days in our adult program is the equivalent of finding 50 new friends and having lots of conversations about what you want, what your goals are for your life, what you want to accomplish, what you need to learn. And, you know, to contrast that 2 days with sitting at home in front of a TV or just by yourself, it just doesn't take a lot to understand how life-changing it can be to be able to get a little bit of financial aid to these families so that they can help their sons or daughters.
Thank you so much for anything you're able to do to support the Flourish Fund. Every little bit makes a difference for us.
In terms of doing something that's going to have a ripple effect that changes lives for such a long time and in such a dramatic way, the Flourish Fund is about as good as it's ever going to get. We don't have to wait on anyone else, on the government, or any other organization to create that solution. That's why I'm giving to the Flourish Fund.